Leonard, not Mike.
These guys were Leonard's. Mike doesn't fit engineers.
Quick, call for backup!
So they get the credit? No way! I'm fed up with them making fun of us just because we're engineers.
You're right, Leonard. They treat us like nobodies because we don't carry a rifle. Our weapon is our intellect. To the controls! We'll tell them we saw the prisoner. Ha ha ha! Activating radio saw.
Guys, you're engineers. Don't play soldiers with me, okay? I won't hurt you. Come on, let me pass. I'll give you some trading cards.
Eat a dick!
Fine. I don't know what you have on those computers, but any unsaved work is going to get lost.
The saws were controlled by the terminals. I only had to destroy them. And with all the noise in the hangar, a few explosions wouldn't draw any attention. But I had to be careful not to kill the engineers, and heal them in case they got injured.
Son, do you copy?
Copy, Colonel.
Still in that hangar?
Yes, Colonel. Still trying to figure out how to get out of here. By the way, guess what? They have a mini rescue submarine.
Rescue? These people don't look like they go around rescuing people.
I'm getting inside to have a look. Maybe I can ride it out of here. Well, look at what we have here. Fiddling with the controls, levers, and compartments, I managed to discover the submarine's logbook. It contained details about its last mission, a rescue operation. The details didn't catch my attention at first, but this logbook turned out to hold exactly the answers we were looking for. The fourth document was the logbook of a mini rescue submarine. It mentioned its last mission, a successful rescue operation from a week ago. The target was a sinking submarine. The K-278 Consomolets, suffering from an onboard fire in the Barents Sea. Apparently, two nuclear torpedoes were salvaged during the job. The warheads involved in Operation Jericho. The third file of Operation Jericho was quite revealing. It had a map of the Kantor province with exact coordinates, an ambush plan, and a picture of the colonel with his name under it. Apparently their plan was to kidnap the colonel without leaving a trace. The second file of Operation Jericho was a compendium of coded numbers. It also had a map, so those numbers could be the coordinates of attack routes, or potentially the attack targets themselves. The first file was about an attack plan. Its code name was Operation Jericho. I couldn't find many details because it was encoded. But anyone could understand a chart about casualties. Its lines went all the way to the top. before leaving the submarine, I decided to report to Harris about the documents. Jesse here, do you copy?
I hear you.
Hey, how did they catch you?
I was in the outskirts of Katsala, taking some pictures of a bunch of military trucks. There was too much security. They were obviously hiding something. I couldn't clearly see what they were loading, so I got closer. Turns out, I got too close. Next thing you know, I was surrounded by a bunch of pricks aiming rifles at my head.
Did you at least manage to see what they were loading?
Sure did, but I was disappointed.
What did you see?
Concrete.
Concrete? Are you kidding?
Two huge rectangular concrete blocks. Each could barely fit into a truck.
You were imprisoned for a piece of concrete? Fuck, man. I'd be disappointed too.
Too much security for something so mundane. But enough about me. You should get back to your escape, my friend.
Jesse here. Over.
Did you find anything, Fox?
I found a logbook with a single recorded mission. It says, Mission, Deep Rescue, successfully completed. Return date. Fuck, a week ago. I'll continue reading. Rescue in the Barents Sea. Objective, Submarine K-278 Komsomolets.
Damn it, the Komsomolets.
Have you heard of it?
Of course. It's a Soviet submarine that sank after catching fire. But I can't think of any connection between these scum and the Soviets.
Maybe they're a Russian faction and went to rescue their comrades. Or they could be trying to trade the crewmen for Russian nukes or something.
Fox, this wasn't a rescue mission.
But the log says...
The Komsomolets sank over a year ago. There's not a soul alive down there. It's not people they were hauling. It was something else.
Colonel, what was the sub armed with?
As far as I know, two nuclear torpedoes. Fuck!
There it is. The nuclear warheads for Operation Jericho. Kindly donated by the Soviet Union in a game of Finders Keepers.
If what you say is true, they had to bring those torpedoes in by sea and take them to a lab. The whole Komsomolets have been contaminated by the radiation. Which means they would need a sarcophagus.
A sarcophagus? Like the one for Tutankhamun? Did you smoke something, Colonel?
Don't be an idiot, Fox. A sarcophagus is something that confines radiation, preventing everyone from dying while they transport the goods. It has to be something thick, heavy.
Like two huge concrete blocks. Fuck, I have to call Robert.
Fox, wait.
What's up, Colonel?
I hear footsteps. Soldiers are walking down the hall. Damn it. I think my time is up. Listen to me carefully, son. The situation is critical. You have to escape as soon as possible and call the Cavalier. Understood? The fate of countless people rests on you, Fox. Colonel Harris out.
That was my final communication with Colonel Harris. Robert, still there.
Yep. Fox, looks like you're gonna transfer a prisoner. Someone called Alan Harris.
I know. Do you know what they plan to do?
No idea, Fox. But looks like the orders are coming from top brass. You're really pissing them off, my friend. Be careful. Maybe they'll use him against you.
I'll keep that in mind. By the way, I have something to tell you about your concrete.
Don't tell me him. Man, you rock.
I don't know where they are, but they've been used as a sarcophagus.
A sarcophagus? Like the one for Tutankhamun? Did you smoke something, Fox?
Of course not. I mean a thick container to contain radiation.
Radiation? Please tell me they're not nukes.
They are, from a sunken Soviet submarine.
Shit. That's why there's so much secrecy and surveillance.
Cheer up, Robert. Your capture isn't for something trivial anymore. It's for a nuclear arms race.
Fuck! This news is da bomb!
That's a literal way to say it.
Keep me informed, my friend. I want to know all the deets.
I will, Robert. Over and out. finally located a recycling bin. I've been needing one for a while.
Why the hell did you need a recycling bin?
To get rid of some stuff.
But couldn't you just toss them on the ground?
Are you taking me for some sort of shitbag?
You were behind enemy lines. It wouldn't be unreasonable.
Look, Lieutenant, I don't abandon my principles at the first sign of adversity.
I see. Now, why did you get rid of items that may be handy later?
Because the more stuff you have, the more you're a slave to your own possessions. And nothing enslaves me. So, I threw away everything that I didn't need. An act that's common to minimalists, such as yourself.
Minimalist? Me? Where'd you get that stupid idea?
Take a look at yourself. You look angry and disappointed. As if you're having minimalist intercourse.
How dare you!
Relax, Sergeant. It's obvious what Mr. Fox is trying to do. We've been here for a long time. We're tired, even slightly agitated. Mr. Fox is trying to take advantage of that by getting on my nerves with petty insults. Hoping I attack him and provide an officer misconduct charge that enables him to be set free. But that is not going to work, Mr. Fox. Look, I'm used to interrogating assholes like you.
Fuck. You got me, officer. I underestimated you. Fuck. I have to admit that you're very good.
Well, thanks. Let's continue. You said that you got rid of some items.
After putting the key in the lock and turning it, the sub started to move. I took the mini submarine through underground channels beneath the hangar.
Seriously? Now you can drive mini submarines?
Nope. Never done it before in my life. But I found a manual.
Can you read Russian?
Of course not. It was in English. The mini submarine was American. It was a pretty smooth ride. I didn't have to worry about the battery levels, oxygen, or depth. And the inside was very comfortable. I could practically live in there.
Well, of course. It's an American product. What did you expect?
Yeah, but you know how American vehicles are. They practically explode on contact. Ever seen an action movie? Anyways, that's why I avoided any hard collisions.
Thank you.
Had to feel lonely, locked in that submarine underwater.
Nah, I had some company.
You had to feel lonely, locked in that submarine.
Boss defeated.
I ended up in what looked like a dock. There were containers and stuff. The sea was slightly rough. Oh, and there was a storm. Under the rain and the biting cold, the Colonel's fate gnawed at my mind. According to Robert, they were moving him. Was it a routine inspection? Would he be returned to his cell? Would they find the radio? He was an old, annoying, tiresome man, but I feared for his life. Until the radio chimed in. It was Channel 1. Colonel, what happened? Are you okay?
I'm fine, Mr. Fox, thank you for asking, but my rank is General, not Colonel.
Wait, you're General X?
So, Mr. Fox, have you heard? You've become quite the celebrity. I've been dying to meet you since your debut. So I took this hack job of a radio to call you before your inevitable capture.
Where's the Colonel?
Don't worry about him. He's in good hands. Say hello, Colonel.
Fox, run away! Don't listen to this bastard! Get your hands off me, you fucking moron!
Colonel!
Seniors say such silly things. I join him in wishing you a happy escape, but you know too much. Sooner or later, you will make a mistake. One that'll prove fatal.
We'll see about that, General.
Escaping prisoner.
Nothing interesting. Useless stuff.
Is she yours?
She is. I look after her like a treasure.
I want to buy her.
Ha ha ha! This beauty costs $50 million. I doubt you can afford it.
Just 50 million? I'm a few dollars short. Hold on. I'm going to the ATM.
This escape was going to cost me a lot of money, so I searched in the containers.
Why in the containers?
It's how people usually smuggle money. Nothing interesting. Nothing interesting. Nothing useful. Useless stuff. Useless stuff. Nothing interesting. Nothing interesting. Nothing useful. Useless stuff. Useless stuff. Nothing interesting. Useless stuff. Useless stuff. Nothing in this. Nothing interesting. Nothing interesting. Nothing interesting.
Money.
Fuck! So much money! That's Scrup is all yours. Here's the key.
And that's how I bought the ship I would finally escape in. If only a lightning bolt didn't split her in two.
Shit! Why are you giving me back the keys?
I want my money back.
Haha! Sorry! No refunds!
Shit! Nothing interesting. Useless stuff. Nothing interesting.
Are you telling me that a nuclear submarine attacked you?
That's what I'm saying.
I see. And now you're going to tell me you fought it instead of running away.
Of course. I would have left it alone if it didn't launch its missiles. And nobody launches missiles at me without permission.
useless stuff.
Thank you.
Boss defeated.
My triumph was fleeting. The platform collapsed after the ballistic abuse from all the missiles.
Mr. Fox, did you just sink one of my submarines?
She attacked first.
Ah, then it was you. Thank you for revealing your position.
Hey, Fox, are you there?
Here I am, Robert.
Fox, the comms are fucking lit. They're sending everything they have to the docks. What the hell did you do?
I just sank a nuclear submarine. That'll teach it not to launch its missiles at me.
Are you kidding me?
I'm serious. Good thing it wasn't armed with nuclear warheads. They must be saving them for Operation Jericho.
Speaking of nukes, hearing a lot of chatter that they're prepping there to the Omega building. Man, if you don't stop them, there's gonna be a worldwide bloodbath.
I won't be stopping them.
But who else will?
I don't care, Robert. Right now, I don't need to be recruited by another colonel to save the world. Right now, I just need to save my ass. And the moment I find anything, even a pull float, I'm getting the hell out of here.
Do you copy?
Mr. Fox, did you...
Hey, friend, still there?
Inside that hangar, I found what I was looking for. Boats I needed to escape. There was a Zodiac motorboat and a hovercraft. The Zodiac was the faster and more maneuverable choice in the water. But hovercrafts were versatile and could pass over terrain where Zodiacs could not. As I checked the Zodiac, I found out that... its gas tank was empty. As I checked the hub... the key to start the engine was missing.
Mr.
It wasn't wise to use weapons there. It wasn't wise to use weapons there. Yeah. wasn't wise to use weapons there.
Thank you.
wasn't wise to use weapons there. Wasn't wise to use weapons. Wasn't wise to use wasn't wise to use.
Boss defeated.
The confrontation with that chopper exhausted every drop of gas I had left. With no gas, the engine stopped shortly thereafter. Despite the dangers, I used my own arms to paddle forward. Piranhas and crocodiles constantly tried to eat my hands. But I was lucky enough to make it to a small dock.
You're certainly a lucky man, Mr. Fox.
Oh, please, don't kill me.
Why would I want to kill you?
Hold on. You're not one of those bastards.
Of course not. I'm a very nice guy. By the way, what are you doing?
Those bastards won't stop building fences everywhere. They think the jungle is theirs, so I cut them to fuck with them.
Do you have, by any chance, a van to get out of here?
I had one, but they took it away.
The old man told me a few stories about that place. It was isolated, with no roads or towns nearby. And most importantly, he told me about what I might encounter up ahead. There, hidden in the middle of the jungle, stood a compound riddled with cameras. The level of security was sky high, like the mansion of a cartel boss, and I could see why. Because the center of this fortress was the Omega Building, the heart of Operation Jericho. The old man told me that he saw some helicopters landing on top of the building. If I stole one of them, that would be my ticket out of there. One thing was for sure. If I was detected by a camera and the alarm triggered, they would put the Omega Building in lockdown and I could kiss those helicopters goodbye. But none of that matters because even though I was already showing signs of exhaustion, I slid in like a shadow and managed to go undetected. The door was locked and chained. There was nobody outside. So finding the key for the lock wasn't an option. I could cut the chain with a bolt cutter, but where would I find one?
Hello, friend.
Give me that bolt cutter.
But it's mine.
Now it's mine.
Wait. Are you saying that you stole from some defenseless old man? You're a special sort of monster.
What? Me? No. I paid him. When I said it was practically highway robbery, I meant...
Hello, friend.
Hello, Gramps. I want to buy that bolt cutter.
But it's mine. How much are you willing to pay?
Here are some coins.
It's little money, pal.
Oh, look. I also have $10 million.
Okay.
Thank you, Gramps.
You're welcome, kid.
Thank you.
On the east side, the cameras were accompanied by guards. I needed to pass without being spotted by Mike or the camera. So, I had to get rid of Mike and leave no witnesses. But it was more complicated than that. If the camera saw Mike knocked out, lying on the ground, the alarm would be triggered.
Seems you just had to move him away from the view of the camera.
Exactly. But, if Mike wasn't there as the camera viewed his post, the alarm would still be triggered. Whatever I did, the camera had to see Mike standing at his post.
Quite the scenario. Unless it's an episode of MacGyver, it would be impossible to proceed. Hold on. If you're telling me this, that means you made it through, correct?
Well, yes, I managed to fool the camera eventually.
How did you manage that?
If the camera needed to see Mike, I could just make a copy of him.
A clone?
Yes. The copy was so perfect, Mike's mother wouldn't know the difference. I made the swap when the camera wasn't looking.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar.
Yes, sir.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? Didn't you say that the alarm never... Didn't you say that the alarm never set? Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar.
Yes, sir.
Didn't you say that the alarm never... Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar.
Yes, sir.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar.
Yes, sir. Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar. Yes, sir.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar.
Yes, sir.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this. Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself.
There it was, the entrance to the Omega building. That would be the last place I'd visit on my tour de escape.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting. Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded?
I was so hungry that I ate the pepperoni bits left over on the cardboard. But as I opened the box, the steam from within disappeared.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar.
Yes, sir.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded?
is this?
I have a pizza here for Mike?
That's me, but I didn't order one.
Fuck. The pizzeria screwed up again. They must have repeated the last order. My God, they suck at managing orders. And this is so far away.
Are you sure you don't want it? It's just out of the oven.
Hold on. Show me the pizza.
Here it is.
Yeah, I see it. What kind of pizza is it?
It's a mushroom and arugula pizza.
What's arugula?
It's an Italian herb with intense flavor.
Fuck. Is that the kind of pizza that looks like it has grass on it?
Well, yeah, it's green.
Do I look like a sheep? Besides, isn't this a repeated order? Why is this a different pizza?
Dunno. Maybe it's for another Mike?
Hold on. You're not the same pizza guy. Fuck, you're an imposter!
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded?
Who is this?
I have a pizza here for... It's a margarita pizza.
Margarita?
It has tomato, mozzarella, and oregano.
Don't fuck with me. That's what all pizzas have. You brought me a pizza with nothing else on it? Do I look like a dumbass or what? Besides, isn't this a repeated order? Why is this a different pizza?
Dunno. Maybe it's for another...
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded?
I have a pizza here. It's a four cheese pizza.
You've got to be joking. I'm lactose intolerant. Besides, isn't this a repeated order? Why is this a different pizza?
Dunno. Maybe it's for another Mike?
Hold on. You're not the same pizza guy. Fuck, you're...
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar. Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded?
I have a pizza here for... It's a mushroom and arugula pizza.
What's arugula?
It's an Italian herb with intense flavor.
Fuck. Is that the kind of pizza that looks like it has grass on it?
Well, yeah.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar. Didn't you say that the alarm never Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded?
Who do you think I am? I'm Mike. Open up.
Hold on while we check. But wait, you're not Mike.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded?
Who is this?
Hello. Good evening. Look, my son needs to pee. And he really needs to go to the bathroom. Could you let me in, please?
I'm sorry, we can't let children inside.
But he's about to pee himself. It'll be everywhere. Walls, doors, ceilings.
There's a toilet just after you enter the compound. There he'll be able to pee and save his game.
I was so hungry that I ate the pepperoni bits left over on the cardboard. But as I opened the box, the steam from within disappeared.
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded?
I have a pizza here for Mike. It's a mushroom and arugula pizza.
What's arugula?
Didn't you say that the alarm never sounded? You're contradicting yourself. Sergeant, execute this liar.
Yes, sir.
I carefully studied that pizza box, examining every detail, every clue, every molecule. I deduced that it was used by someone else to smuggle something into the Omega building.
A pizza?
Exactly. A pepperoni pizza, to be precise. I have a pizza here for... It's a pepperoni pizza.
Great. The kind I like.
As I crossed the door, I entered into the Omega building, the heart of Operation Jericho. It was a cold, dark, industrial place with containers and barrels everywhere. On my right, there was the control room where they monitored the outer cameras. And, of course, the asshole that controlled them. The guy I tricked with the pizza, who was coming over to get it. Reality was going to hit him in the face.
Give me the fucking pizza and get out.
Of course. Here you are, friend.
I'm not your friend, buddy. What the fuck? It doesn't weigh shit. Son of a bitch. You bake these thinner by the hour. It's empty. Where the hell is my pizza?
Look at what's on the box.
What? Where?
I was inside the Omega building. I just had to reach the rooftop and pray that I'd find a helicopter.